Over the years, scientists have increased extraterrestrial research to find out whether there is life and people beyond our solar system. This had elicited a lot of interest in this subject. One of such planets that elicits a lot of interest and which was thought to be having some kind of life is Mars. However, the theory finally fizzled out after discovering that Mars doesn't have oxygen and instead is full of methane gas, therefore ruling out the theory of life in Mars. However, scientists are still exploring the extraterrestrial for anything that they could find to prove the existence of life. 46 years ago, spacecraft Voyager 1 and 2 were launched on 20th August and 5th September 1977 respectively, and have since traveled 14,528 billion and 7 billion kilometers respectively. And yet in these 46 years of travel, none of these spacecrafts has found any signs of life. According to scientists, Voyager 1 flew beyond the heliopause and was the first known spacecraft made by humans to have crossed into interstellar space. And it will merge from the old cloud in another 14 to 28,000 years to come. Both Voyager 1 and 2 will pass other stars in about 40,000 years to come. Meaning, those spacecrafts are too far away. And yet, they have not reached the end. Let's be honest to ourselves. Will be there to witness or bring any conclusion where they'll end? Will be there to carry on? That is why we should all agree that God exists and dwells far, far away in the heavens, that no any human-made spacecraft can reach him. That's why he says in Isaiah 57 verse 15, I live in a high in a holy place. Where is heaven situated and how far? In Ephesians 1, 20 to 21, the Bible says, he exalted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heaven realms, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion. And every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the age to come. Meaning, Jesus went far above any known planet or stars. Far above any human-made spacecraft can reach. Also in John 7:34, Jesus told the Pharisees who are trying to argue with Jesus, you will look for me, but will not find me. And where I go, you cannot come. Jesus knew exactly where he was going. He knew these guys would never ever reach him. It was too far for them. 2 Corinthians 5, 1, the Bible says, for we know that if the earthly tent is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not built by human hands. Meaning heaven is a place where righteous people continue to live. If there are evidence of life in heaven, yes, let's see. For a number of years, scientists have tried to explore the possibility of extraterrestrial civilization and possibly find life. However, the truth of the matter is, there is life already in existence in that super earth. There is undeniably fact that the place supports life which the Bible corroborates. Evidence number one, there is water, palm trees, and even fruits. In Revelation 7 verse 9, it says, after this I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. It means palm trees grow in heaven. Well, you may ask, is there oxygen? Well, what we know here on earth is oxygen may not necessarily be called oxygen in heaven. Evidence number two, there is a river, fruits, and seasons. This is found in Revelation chapter 22 and verse 2. It says, on each side of the river stood the tree of life, bearing 12 crops of fruit every month. And the leaves of the tree are for the healing of the nations. That means in heaven there are also seasons. Isn't that interesting? Evidence number 3. There is food. Saints will be eating heavenly food. The eating may not necessarily be to sustain life as it is here in this planet, but rather it will be for our enjoyment, just like the way we like enjoying food here in this world. This evidence is corroborated by the Bible in Revelation 19 verse 9. It says, then the angel said to me, write this. Blessed are those who are invited to the wedding supper of the Lamb. And he added, these are the true words of God. Now, let's take an example. When Jesus resurrected from the dead, he was in a glorious body, but he ate food. If Jesus ate after resurrection in a good, glorious body, we too will eat together with him. We find this in Luke 24 verse 41. And while they still did not believe it because of joy and amazement, he asked them, do you have anything here to eat? They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Isn't that wonderful? Even after he has resurrected, he was able to eat. Now, this shows even after we resurrect, gone into heaven, we'll be given this glorious body, but also be able to eat. Angels too eat heavenly food. That is found in Psalm 78 verse 24. He rained down manna for people to eat. He gave them the grain of heaven. Human being ate the bread of angels. Now I know you are going to ask, will we find bread in heaven? According to the Bible, yes. Will we find food in heaven? Yes. Where will we get the teeth? I don't know. But the Bible says we will eat. With the heaven, everything will be changed beyond our understanding. What are the requirements to get to heaven? You have to be born again by accepting Jesus Christ as your Savior. We find this in John 1 verse 12. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or husband's will, but born of God. Romans 10 verse 9 says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you'll be saved. But those who deny Jesus Christ and say they'll bypass him and go straight to God, they'll be in for a shock of life when they'll be denied entry and told no entry. Many will be shocked to see that they are not known in heaven but known in hell. Angels will be counter-checking the names of each one of us in the heaven database to find out if someone's name is written in the book of life, which is God's database. Many who are mere religious people will find themselves, their names are missing. Revelation 20 verse 15. Anyone who was not found written in the book of life was thrown into the lake of fire. Many will curse their religious leaders who misled them. It will be too late. This word you have heard today will judge you and stand as a witness against you on that day. You'll have no excuse unless you accept Jesus now as your Savior. All other religious efforts are worthless. The true salvation is found in none other than Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. God bless you.